हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज राजीव सन्नेकी, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ सिविल इंजीनियरिंग, जैन पॉलिटेक्निक, बेलगावी. सो नाउ वी आर गेटिंग इनटू मोर इंटरेस्टिंग पार्ट्स इन यूनिट वन, दैट इज इंट्रोडक्शन टू आरसीसी. सो इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल बी कवरिंग टू पोर्शंस, दैट इज लेक्चर नंबर 9 एंड लेक्चर नंबर 10 फ्रॉम यूनिट 1. सो द कंटेंट इन दिस टू लेक्चर्स आर, that is introduction of singly reinforced beam or singly reinforced section, doubly reinforced section. Next is analysis of singly reinforced beam. Next is analysis of doubly reinforced beam. So first we come to singly reinforced beam. So before we studied about what is RCC, the R stand for reinforcement or reinforced, we are reinforcing steel. So here the name itself makes us understand singly reinforced sections, means in this part or in a section the reinforcement is provided singly or in only one part. So here in singly reinforced sections, that reinforcement of the steel is provided only in one zone, that is tension zone. And in case of doubly reinforced section, the steel is provided in both the zone, that is compression zone as well as tension zone. So here you can see a figure which shows singly reinforced section and doubly reinforced section. So how the steel are provided in two different sections. Next is T-beam. T-beams are nothing but beams which are connected to slabs which form a junction. They are also in the shape of L, which are at the edges of the slab. So it is a load bearing structure of reinforced concrete, wood or metal with T-shaped cross section. So here in T-beam, the upper part, that is the slab, acts as a flange, or it is called as a flange, and the lower part it is called as rib or web. So here you can see a figure of a T-beam. Upper part is flap, flange, the lower part is web, where the upper part takes the compressive loads or compressive stresses. So here you can see the arrangement of reinforcement in a simply supported beam. This is a longitudinal section and this is a cross section, that is section at AA. How the bars are bent at the end, where both the forces, the tensile and compressive forces, are acting. Next is reinforcement arrangement in cantilever beam. Previous it was simply supported, now it is cantilever. In a cantilever beam, again both sections are provided, longitudinal and cross section. How the bar is projected from the column to the cantilever beam, that is hanging. Next is analysis of singly reinforced beam. So here you have to understand, before analysis, stress distribution and stress block parameters, which we have discussed in the previous lecture as per IS-456. So the determination in analysis of singly reinforced beam are, you have to determine the depth of neutral axis and the maximum limiting depth of neutral axis. Analysis of doubly reinforced beam. In design type, you have to determine that given data will be B, small d, capital D, and grade of concrete and steel. So we have to determine ASC and AST, because since it is a double reinforced beam, steel is provided in both the sections. So in case In this case, we have to find out AST, that is area of steel in tension zone, ASC, area of steel in compression zone, from given factor moment. So these design problems can be solved by two ways, by use of equations which are developed from W reinforced beam, that is computation method, and second one is what they say, by using SP16 charts. And SP16 is a special chart where SP stands for a special publication. Thank you.